Today, we will discuss if there's really such a huge difference between working Bull and Terriers and show Bull and Terriers. And the reasoning was that show Greyhounds, for example, are still extremely fast dogs as compared to other dogs and have not decreased their speed that much as compared to working Greyhounds, so to say. And it is true that also show Greyhounds are quite fast, very fast dogs, so to say. But working Greyhounds are faster still and also less prone to injury. I even stated that a small amount of bull in a Greyhound lurcher, so bull grey, for example 25%, would be faster chasing a quarry, and perhaps even a 50% bull grey would be faster in chasing a quarry than a purebred show Greyhound will be. And it gives you quite an indication. Another thing is in the Greyhound, and then I will stop with this, is that the Greyhound has not changed that much in time. If you look at the old pictures of Greyhounds and with it, you see that they are quite similar. So they haven't been ruined by over-exaggeration. And this is not true with many other breeds, especially some of the Bull and Terrier or Bulldog breeds. Examples, if you look at the English Bull Terrier, the Roman head, the bow or chest that you see nowadays, completely different to the original English Bull Terrier, which was already a show dog, but bred out of Bull and Terrier and White Terrier stock. Another thing is, if you, in my opinion, what makes a dog? A bulldog in the past, or a Bull and Terrier, or a pit dog in the past, was that because it was able to perform that task, not based on genetic purity or something like that. So some people might say, oh, my dog is so pure and it must be still carrying a lot of Bull and Terrier traits, even though it is a show dog. But this, in my opinion, is not true. If you have Staffordshire Bull Terriers which have pug or French Bulldog infusion and look like just a caricature of the real deal, and it might be that a Border Terrier would perform better even at the original task of the Staffordshire Bull Terrier. As a hunting dog, I can imagine they will be better. But also, Border Terriers are not that much of a working breed anymore. Most also are over-exaggerated. There are just a limited supply of working Border Terriers left, mainly because of this little breed, the Pretzel Terrier, which has just completely eradicated because it has a better working ability in most cases than Border Terriers have. I also gave another example, that is that of the English Bulldog, because as I mentioned also the Bulldog blood, some are completely ruined. If you look at the old English Bulldog, the one that was still a working dog, the look would be close to that of a Staffordshire Bull Terrier or an American Pit Bull Terrier, and that they would resemble the modern day show English Bulldog, which has lost completely its ability to do the original task. And even a pit dog, for example American Pit Bull Terrier, would be far better at dealing with a bull than a showbred English Bulldog, because they don't have the jaw strength, the nose is too short, they don't have a good grip, completely destroyed by infusion of other breeds and just romantic stories instead of performance. I also mentioned some other Bull and Terrier breeds, for example the Boston Terrier, which was in the past also a pit dog, and the Pretzel Terrier that you see here. They can both weigh the same weight, Of course, you have a range where you can find both breeds, but if you have them at the same weight, that Boston Terrier cannot touch. That all-time Bull Terrier cannot touch a modern-day working Bull Terrier such as the Pachydil on anything. In the past, those Boston Terriers might be mighty pit dogs, but now they have trouble at whelping their pups to giving birth. They will have a very high prone for catching a cold and other diseases. Their eyes are almost bulging out. They don't have a good grip in their snout. They're completely ruined. They look nice and they can be very funny and nice dogs, which have characteristics of the Bull Terrier breeds, of course. But this is not the same. In my opinion, a non-functional dog is completely different than a functional working type of dog. Well, I hope this video helped and gave some additional insights to the story. Hope you have a great day. Bye bye. One of my subscribers told an interesting fact that they found in a book, that it was noted that once a cross between American Pit Bull Terrier and I think Sandhound beat a proper American Pit Bull Terrier. Well, as I replied then, I will also give a little bit more insight in this video. Is I think, yeah, that genetics, of course, can once in a while click very well, and you can have enormous hybrid figure, of course. But I don't think that a sidehound or a sandhound has anything to add to an American Pit Bull Terrier of breeding, and especially because hounds are normally bred to chase, yeah, but not so much to engage. They're more there to bay at the prey and to bark at it, so to say. Whereas a Bull Terrier or an American Pit Bull Terrier would be there to engage and also to withstand enormous amounts of pain if necessary, and to really combat, to wrestle, to fight, and all those traits are not present in hounds. And I also replied that in the past it is known that there was a cross in England between a Wheaton Terrier and a Staffordshire Bull Terrier that performed very well, and also crosses between different type of bull and terrier breeds are nowadays still performing well. If you look at the performance bred Wheaton Terriers, they often carry a little bit of bull, American Pit Bull Terrier blood, to revigorate themselves. So it is not a coincidence that in many breeds the American Pit Bull Terrier or other Bull and Terrier breeds are infused to improve upon them. And you grant them courage, determination, strength, wrestling ability. That's a good thing in most breeds. But a Wheaton Terrier being a hunting dog, to a degree, and a hound being a hunting dog, means they are both hunting dogs, but they have a completely different style. A terrier is also very confrontational and also made up of the original Bull and Terrier recipe. Eh? There was bulldog blood, which at the time, the bulldog blood looked a lot like the purebred American Pit Bull Terrier or Staffordshire Bull Terriers that we know today already. Eh? So still controversial how much terrier blood is in there. But it is a fact that both bulldogs and terriers were involved in blood sports in the pits, being in the red pit or against each other. So that would be far more likely. And also, as I mentioned, for example, the Wheaton Terrier cross Staffordshire Bull Terrier was capable, and you get a lot of heterosis. Stormer was also a cross between Staffordshire Bull Terrier of performance lines and English Bull Terrier, also of working lines, and it also gave that dog enormous heterosis. So I can imagine that terrier blood and Bull and Terrier blood, or a little bit of bulldog blood, can work. It's also known that there were some dogs that carried a little bit of American Bulldog blood in the heavyweight division. Of course, you get a lot stronger dog then. If you look at a Scott type American Bulldog, you see that they still have a lot of the original characteristics of the English Bulldogs, only bigger. The English Bulldogs that were still performing. Also the Painter Margarita type of American Bulldog carries quite a lot of American Pit Bull Terrier blood in its veins. So that's more likely than that hound blood. So what happened with that hound blood? Who knows? No one was there. But the fact is that people lie, even though about purebred Bulldogs. And in this case, I mean how the American Pit Bull Terrier fanciers call their dogs, also Bulldogs, or Hollis Bulldogs. But they also lie about those pure dogs. I can imagine that they would also be twisting the truth to a degree on this hound, the American Pit Bull Terrier cross, that defeated the big and strong purebred American Pit Bull Terrier. It's quite unlikely, but sometimes also coincidence can happen. In all kinds of things, if something goes really amiss, there could be that freak incident, but that would be hard to reproduce. Well, have a great day.